Using the beautiful soup module, we can take all this code that we wrote fairly painstakingly in the first three units of the class, and I know that now that you're a fairly experienced programmer, it doesn't seem too hard to write this code, but this code is actually very fragile. It only works on very specific ways of encoding link targets, and we could replace that with much simpler code that uses far fewer lines and works much better. We're doing that by importing from BS4, which is the beautiful soup library, the beautiful soup definition, which allows us to create an object that represents a web page. Here we're passing in the contents of the page just like we were doing in getAllLinks. And the beautiful soup module provides definitions that give us a very easy way to extract all the links from a web page. In the first part of the course where we were writing this code ourselves, well, we wanted to really understand how to do things and our goal was to learn about programming. If you're actually trying to solve problems, you're much better off finding a module like Beautiful Soup where someone's already put a lot of effort into figuring out how to do this in the right way and written a tool that works much more robustly on much more complex web pages than the code that we wrote does. So modules are a real big win, and we can use this without worrying about it polluting our namespace because we know the only name that we've imported here is the name Beautiful Soup. And we've replaced these 18 lines of code with 6 lines that, if you understand what the module does, are much easier to understand and much simpler than having to understand all 18 lines. And they work a lot better. So modules are a huge win. They make it very easy to share code. And one of the things you should be thinking about as you develop more programs, especially if you're developing them to actually solve problems, not just to learn about programming, if there's a module that already exists that you can use to make your coding much more simple.